Oh, I'm definitely gonna get Cyberpunk, and I'm definitely gonna get the Mass Effect trilogy remake. I've never played any of the Mass Effect. I played the first Mass Effect game, maybe for like an hour back when it first came out, and I don't know why, but I couldn't really get into it. And then I never touched it again because other games came out. So I'm gonna give it another shot. Because I've always liked BioWare games. I really like Dragon Age because I like fantasy more than sci-fi, but I think I'm gonna give it a shot and see if I can learn to love it.
That's a curious way to get along.
Cyberpunk is a definite I already know I'm gonna enjoy that game just because of I like the cyberpunk theme, and it's CD Projekt Red, so I know it's gonna be good. I know, I heard that the first game was a little bit slow and rough around the edges, but the second was a lot better, and then I heard that three was like, eh. You know, I guess the not a lot of people were excited by the ending of three. Yeah, but I de definitely heard that two was the best. What the fuck? What the fuck was that? It may have also been that number one, believe it or not. Like, maybe it felt a little overwhelming just 'cause, like, I don't know. There's a lot, like, so much to do in that game. And at the time, like, I wasn't really used to that yet. Like, I played Oblivion, I played The Witcher 3, you know, since then. And those games also, like, I think I spent like 200 hours on Witcher 3.
Why are
And I
you
did
up here?
everything, you know, and then for some reason that game wasn't as overwhelming to me just because I was like so hooked on it. But I'll definitely give it Mass Effect a shot now that it's keep getting remade, remastered, not remade. Honestly, right now, I just can't wait to play through Valhalla. And that game is like, I'm gonna play through that game until I finish it. I'm not gonna play anything else once I get my Series X. Not sure if I'll be able to finish it before Cyberpunk comes out, but I'm thinking that after Valhalla, Cyberpunk, and then I'll try to just focus on Cyberpunk.
Please. Help.
And then I also want to play through Legion on my Series X. Because I also got that game too.
Please.
Oh, that is impressive.
Help.
Yeah, but I feel like they were in a lose-lose scenario 3 because they were done with Shepard, but they didn't know how to make something that final enough to end the trilogy, but still leave the world open to have other
Please.
stories. Yeah, that's
Help.
true. That's true, it's, you know, it definitely seems like it was hard to tie up some of the loose ends and stuff like that, and they weren't really sure where
Please.
to go with it.
You must be one of Bartolomeo's men.
Oh,
What's
damn.
happened here? Where is he?
Silvio
Oh, he got
struck,
shot.
attacked, took him deeper into the district. North of here.
Requiescat in pace.
Okay, time to find these dudes. Let's see, cage fighter, liberate Bartolomeo D'Alviano from his cage. I don't know if you heard, but they're actually supposedly working on number 4, Mass Effect 4 too, on top of the remastered collection. Wonder if the new one is going to be an Andromeda still, or if they're going to go back to the tried and true. Honestly, I feel like after them fucking up Andromeda, I think that they're probably gonna start fresh. 'Cause I heard that game did poorly as well. Like, that game didn't interest me at all. Because, you know, I was like, eh, I haven't played the other ones. I heard that game did really badly, so I didn't even touch that one. I honestly can't wait for the new Dragon Age, though. I hope they don't mess that up, because it could do so much good with that game. Like, that whole, the way Origins, I mean, not Origins, the way the latest game, like, ended up, it was, like, it was so good. It was actually a really good ending, in my opinion. Like, it was just a plot twist that you didn't really see coming. And so, I really hope that they can do that game justice. Fuck, oh shit. Yeah, Inquisition, that's what it's called. But Andromeda was really good a year after it came out and they fixed all the bugs and glitches. Oh, okay. I guess you're probably in the minority in there because I feel like a lot of other people were just... They kind of, you know, it was already too late for them. I'm low-key afraid for them to pick up Dragon Age and just be a dumpster fire. Wait, what do you mean? Why? I mean, it's the same team, though, I think, right? Inquisition was good. You don't think it was good?
You think I don't know who pulled Silvio's puppet string? I've been fighting his weasel of a master since before most of you were even glimmers in your father's eyes! Please get him! Let me off!
Damn, bro.
Mi unico pensiero sarà spiccarvi dal tronco quelle teste di cazzo e ficcarvele su per il culo!
Oh my god.
Oh, and what a grand display it will be! The likes of which shall be sung of for years to come!
This freaking guy. Born in the town of Alviano in central Italy, Bartolomeo grew up to be a clever and resourceful soldier. After spending several years in Venice, he joined the Orsini family in 1496 to fight against Pope Alexander VI Rodrigo Borgia, who was attempting to seize Orsini territory. The Pope's men had the upper hand, narrowing Bartolomeo's resources down to 3 fortresses, but Bartolomeo continued to hold out. Smelling victory, Cesare Borgia, the Pope's son, cut off his supplies. Then, when all looked lost, Carlo Orsini rode over the hill with his army, joining Bartolomeo to defeat the Pope's men and even wounding Cesare in the face. In 1503, Bartolomeo was hired by Ferdinand II of Spain to help the Spanish army defeat the French and seize the Kingdom of Naples. The following year, he defeated Maximilian I, the Holy Roman Emperor, taking Trieste and Gorizia. Impressed, Venice elected him to the office of Governor General. Everything was coming up roses for him until the disastrous Battle of Agnadello in 1509, when he disobeyed orders to avoid combat and directly attacked the French army. The battle was lost. He was captured and wounded by the French, and the Venetians lost Lombardy, a province that had taken them 800 years exertion to conquer. Damn, furious, Venice refused to help him despite his claim that the French commander had stolen a priceless Venetian artifact, which he was attempting to rescue. Bartolomeo was kept in French prison until 1513, but the French, as we all know, are very forgiving. He was sprung from jail to fight for them, managing to defeat the Swiss with only 300 men in 1515. Later the same year, once restored to his former glory as general of the Venetian army, he was killed besieging Brescia. Venice welcomed his body home with a grand ceremony and buried him in the church of Santo Stefano. Him.
About goddamn time! I don't know if I should kiss you or slap you. Maybe both, just to be safe.
That's quite all right.
Who are you?
I'm Ezio Auditore da Firenze. I'm here to rescue you.
Let's see who winds up rescuing who.
What do you mean?
Oh, wow.
Down there!
Big
stop
man.
Them! Holy. About time! Now. Let's see what you can do!
Yeah, I mean, I think I played for like 5 hours, and I was like, nah, and then picked it up a year later and loved it for how different it was from the original trilogy. No, I mean, I loved Inquisition. I thought it was a very good game. You know, the series got a lot of flack for number 2, but...
Oh, sorry, I've fallen asleep.
You should go.
I think it's the same thing about look what happened to Mass Effect.
There are still more heads to be smashed.
I just have low expectations for most games now. It just keeps you less disappointed.
Why? Are you afraid?
No, just practical. Given that they outnumber us 100-1.
As you wish, bella mia.
You're not wrong, but you know it's not. They're not starting fresh with Dragon Age, so you know, like they did with Andromeda. So I don't think that they can mess it up. They're continuing the story from the DLC, so they have, like, a base, you know? I think I can't climb, so I can't. I have to roll. Okay.
Watch for the large one. Dante is called. Most of Silvio's men are useless, but that one's trouble.
Oh my god. What the fuck? Oh my god. Come on, get him. Jesus. Bro, just fight him. What are you doing? Oh, man. Dude.
Segunda.
He's getting fucked up.
Ah, sweet Frida. How I have missed you.
Silvio set his men to ransacking your place. Prepare yourself for a fight.
If you value your life, you'll stand down.
Never! What good is a man's life if it's not lived free, eh? I'll not go back into a cage.
Then you'll go into the ground. Kill them.
Not sure. Where do you think you're going?
What fun this will be!
This way.
If they do legit co-op in the new Dragon Age, I'd be down. Wouldn't even care. Valhalla need a co-op for raiding parties, that would be lit. Yeah, honestly, I feel like every game could do with co-op. Like, there's, you know, I don't think that there's anything wrong with it. Like, I mean, just look at Dying Light, you know? There's a pretty good story. The cutscenes all play out for the same for everybody, as if you're the same person, but you can just play the game co-op, you know? Like, but, I don't know. Every developer does things differently.
What a mess they've made. Bianca. I hope she is unharmed.
All right. Honestly, I don't think that they are gonna do co-op in Dragon Age, though. As much as I would like them to. I mean, I don't know if you ever tried out or if you ever heard of, they have a PC mod for Skyrim that allows you to do co-op. And I think I tried it out with a friend of mine, with Blasio, the guy that we played League with before, and he, like, we played it and it was actually really good. Like, it was basically the same exact game, but you did it with, you know, in co-op. In this day of gaming, I mean, they should just have it for everything. Yeah, exactly. Throw the model in there and double everything. Yeah, exactly. I agree. Just, you know, make it a little harder.
Bianca! You
know? Is everything all right?
What do you think? Look at this place. And poor Bianca. If something's happened to her. Aha! Oh, my darling. Thank God you're all right. Ezio, meet Bianca. Bianca. Ezio.
Charmed.
So, I know your name, but not why you're here.
I have business with Silvio Barbarigo. I was told you could help.
Ah, it would be my honor.
But it's going to require more than just the two. Three of us to weaken his forces. How do you suggest we proceed?
I'll go and ready my men for battle. While I do this, I'd like you to rescue those who were captured during Silvio's assault. I cannot, in good conscience, leave them behind.
Intesi. I will attend to it at once.
Good luck out there, Ezio.
Leave no man behind. Liberate the mercenaries who are being held captive throughout the Castello district. Okay. 100% believe they wanted to throw in co-op, but then they were like, but what if we just made a whole game for it instead? Thus giving us ESO. I mean, it's a different developer. I mean, you know, an MMO is awesome, but it's not the same thing, you know? Because they're still working on the next Elder Scrolls game. If that was the case, then they would just work on the MMO and not do another Elder Scrolls game. I mean, you know, you have a good point, but like, I don't know, you know, like it's... I feel like that's not exactly it. I'm really not sure, like, at the end of the day, I'm really not sure, you know, like, why more developers don't do co-op. Doesn't seem to make sense to me.
Many thanks for
But I'm
the
sure
aid.
They have a legit
We'd
reason, like...
We'd like to fight with you, if you'll have us.
Andiamo.
Then, on him!
Time for a little
space. Kill him!
Alright, this way.
I don't know if you ever played A Way Out, but that's a perfect example of a co-op game that works very well. I mean, it's two different characters, and the way that the camera splits is interesting. Like, even if you're playing online, it's kind of cool because you're getting to see both players' perspectives all the time. I know it's not, you know, that probably wouldn't work for games like Skyrim and RPGs and stuff like that, but, like, you know, everything's better in co-op. Like, it is. Like, just having the option, you know? Like, you know, like, don't make it. Because that game, see, the difference between that game is that game, you have to play it in co-op. And you can't play by yourself. But, like, you know, just having the option of, like, any game. Like, Saints Row, you know. Because Saints Row did it well, too. GTA would be nice, too, you know. Skyrim, any RPG. New Assassin's Creed games, for sure. Yeah, true. I think that's a good point. Like, they probably don't have a lot of experience in making it co-op, I don't know. I mean, look at the new Ghost Recon games, you know? Those are also co-op. And they work very well. And it's a lot more fun. Those games, on the other hand, though...
Only lead the way.
It's a lot more annoying to play by yourself.
Let's do it.
Oh, that sucks to hear. Yeah, I know. I heard that you guys are no longer really talking. Yeah, I'm still in contact with him. The other day we were playing League. Well, it's actually been a while. It's been like a couple weeks, but. He streams now a little bit here and there. He's been really addicted to Genshin Impact. Hey man, if you want to play that game, I'd be more than welcome to play with you. And I don't need to stream it because I already streamed it twice, so I'm good on that. Because two of my other friends wanted to play that game. That game is definitely worthy of a playthrough at least once.
Monster!
And what's really cool about that game is that you don't even... Only one person needs to own it. Because if the other person doesn't, they can just... they can literally just invite you and you can just have like a... Like it just starts downloading on your Xbox. Like we remember, it's just kind of different stages in our lives. Hmm. I got you. That's good. At least you know. At least you guys are, you know,
this way.
Not in a, you know, bad place. Still don't see why you can't reconcile though.
Together we will crush the Barbarigo.
Like you could live separate lives, but still game together. You know?
I better lie low until this blows over.